And I'm Nathan.
And today is Thursday, January 17th, which means we have one more day till our three-day weekend.
And if you didn't already know, Monday is Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day. That means no school!
But let's get started with our announcements. So if you've been paying attention this week, then you already know that our wrestling team is doing a stellar job this season.
Good job, Rams! Our JV wrestlers who won the round title, shout out to the following wrestlers who placed first at Kaiser Tournament: Jody Dack, Enrique Tuckett, and Micah Davison.
Good job, guys! And our Varsity's Boys team went 3-0, beating Nanakuli, Gahuku, and Leihua this past weekend.
Good job, Radford!
Speaking of outstanding performances, our Varsity Girls Basketball team competes in the OIA Playoff Quarterfinal tonight at 6 p.m. in our own James Allegra Gymnasium. Show your support and check it out! Our final announcements for the juniors and seniors, it's that time of the year again, prom! So get set for Saturday, March 16th at the Hilton Waikiki Beach Hotel. Prom bid sales start next Thursday, January 24th during recess and lunch in room 241. You must sign a prom contract before you can purchase your bids though, but stop by room 14 or 241 to pick up a contract. Also, see flyers on the hallways for more information on bid sale dates and prices. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Solanoa in room 114 or any senior leadership student. Are you going to go to prom?
I don't know, honestly, because I don't have a date.
Well, ladies,
no.
If you need a prom date, Nathan is available. Now we're going to talk about lunch. Today, we are serving roasted pork,
steamed rice,
steamed corn,
rainbow salad,
food of the day,
and milk.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Rams. I'm Nadia.
And I'm Nathan.
And have a Ram
and gnarly day. Bye.
Plant burgers, bean burgers, veggie burgers. There's no shortage of companies trying to develop alternatives to meat. What about sushi? Specifically tuna made without tuna fish, but instead from tomatoes, sesame oil, and soy sauce. Some foodies say serious sushi sticklers may not spring for it, but several others have. When it comes to seafood, are there more than fish in the sea?
The human population is growing exponentially. In 1800, there were about a billion people on Earth. Today, there's more than seven times that. And by 2100, estimates say there could be nearly 12 billion people around the globe. That rapid growth comes with lots of problems. One of the biggest? Our food supply may not be able to keep up. When it comes to seafood, the rising number of consumers, mixed with the growing popularity of foods like sushi, has led to overfishing. The Pacific bluefin tuna is a sushi staple. Its population has fallen 97%.
Demand is only getting higher and higher and higher. And one of the big problems we have today is that we are overfishing tuna, and it's only at 3% at the height of its stock.
That's James Corwell. He's been a chef for over 30 years, and he's the founder of a company called Ocean Hugger Foods. His solution to the dwindling tuna population? Tomatoes. Stay with me.
There's five tastes. So we're familiar with sweet, sour, salty, bitter, but there's the fifth taste called umami, right. And that refers to savory. In sushi in particular, you have soy sauce, you have rice that's high in umami, you have seaweed that's high in umami, you have the tuna that's high in umami. But also that what's high in umami are tomatoes. The only problem is you wouldn't have a great sushi experience if the ahimi tastes like tomatoes. So the real technology that we developed came from the process on how to remove that tomato flavor, keep great texture, but create this kind of neutral platform in which to carry Japanese flavors or Latin American flavors or Mediterranean flavors.
So it's basically like the tomato is a vehicle to get those flavors into your mouth.
Exactly.
Ocean Hugger makes plant-based alternatives to seafood. The tomato tuna is called ahimi. The company is also working on salmon made from carrots and eel made from eggplant.
Well, now let's dig in there.
All right.
And we're going to dip in a little of the soy sauce. It really does look like tuna.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah. That's really good.
Right, now let's have it in sushi roll form. I'm not very good with chopsticks.
I mean, I would totally grab this for lunch as opposed to the regular tuna. I don't have to worry about the mercury. I don't have to worry about, like, you know, killing.
It's delicious, salt plant
tuna.
So I was pleasantly surprised. I mean, it actually tasted good. But if we look even further into the future, there will be less usable land to grow crops like tomatoes and carrots. That's where some scientists think algae comes in. Yep, algae, like pond scum. It might not sound very appetizing, but algae is actually high in protein, and it can grow where other crops can't. All you need is sunlight, air, and water. We're not in dire need of algae-based snacks just yet, but one company called Nonfood wants to get ahead of the curve.
Oh, it smells.
Their first product is called Nonbar, and instead of trying to emulate flavors we already know and love, they decided to embrace the algae.
So I'm gonna try this. It smells a little funky, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, it's gonna take some getting used to.
Can we get away, far away? Let's leave this place. Will you come with me? Are you down to turn your world around? It's you and me tonight.
31 seconds. Start.
Leave.